نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين الرؤوف الرحيم وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه الهادين المهديين. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كلامه المجيد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. بابا زي بلند درود پاک پڑھی الصلاة والسلام الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيد المرسلين وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا خاتم النبيين. فتح باب نبوت پہ بے حد درود، ختم دور رسالت پہ لاکھوں سلام. قابل صد احترام حضرات گرامی قدر، جیسا کہ آپ جانتے ہیں کہ آج کی یہ خوبصورت اور باوقار محفل شعبان المعظم کی آمد اور اس کے فضائل و برکات کے بیان کے لیے سجائی گئی ہے، جس میں تھوڑی ہی دیر کے بعد پوری دنیا کی مشہور و معروف شخصیت اور عظیم روحانی شخصیت فضیلۃ الشیخ شیخ المشائخ حضرت الشیخ محمد ابراہیم اوسی ایفا دامت فیوزکم القدسیہ وہ تشریف لائیں گے اور خطاب فرمائیں گے. ابھی تھوڑی ہی دیر کے بعد محفل کا باقاعدہ آغاز تلاوت کلام پاک سے ہوگا. اس سے پہلے ایک اعلان سماعت کر لیں کہ چونکہ آج محفل ہے اور بہت سی خواتین بھی محفل میں شرکت کے لیے آئی ہیں، تو جو وضو خانہ جو ایبلوشن ایریا مسجد کے نیچے ہے وہ صرف عورتوں کے لیے آج محفل کے دوران استعمال ہوگا، تو جو مرد حضرات ہیں وہ گرین گیٹ اسلامی کالج کے اندر جو وضو خانہ ہے اس کو استعمال کریں. آپ حضرات کا بہت شکریہ. تو محفل کے باقاعدہ آغاز کے لیے تلاوت کلام پاک کے لیے میں دعوت دیتا ہوں ہماری گرین گیٹ موسک کے انتہائی معزز سٹاف ممبر اور اس ادارے کے استاد جناب محترم الحافظ والقاری آدم اقبال صاحب کو کہ آپ تشریف لائیں اور تلاوت کلام پاک سے اس محفل کا باقاعدہ آغاز فرمائیں. تشریف لاتے ہیں جناب محترم الحافظ والقاری آدم اقبال صاحب.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ما كان على النبي من حرج فيما فرض الله له سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله قدرا مقدورا. سبحان الله. الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون. ولا يخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله. وكفى بالله حسيبا. ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرَ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. شانئك هو الأبتر. فصل لربك وانحر. إن شانئك هو الأبتر. آمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عن أبي ذر قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا ذر لأن تغضب فتعلم آية من آيات القرآن خير لك من أن تصلي مئة ركعة. حدیث مبارکہ میں آتا ہے کہ نبی اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم نے حضرت ابو ذر غفاری سے یہ فرمایا کہ ابو ذر غفاری قرآن پاک کی ایک آیت کو سیکھنے پہ اللہ تعالی 100 رکعت نماز نفل پڑھنے سے زیادہ ثواب عطا فرماتا ہے. اونچی آواز سے کہیے سبحان اللہ. ماشاءاللہ. یہ تھے حضرت حافظ القاری آدم اقبال صاحب جو قرآن پاک کی تلاوت کر رہے تھے. اب میں قصیدہ بردشی پڑھنے کے لیے ایک بڑے ہی چھوٹے سے پیارے سے اور معصوم سے بچے کو دعوت دیتا ہوں کہ وہ تشریف لائیں اور آپ کے سامنے قصیدہ بردشی پڑھیں. اس خوش نصیب بچے کا نام ہے, کیا نام ہے بچے؟ محمد حسن. محمد حسن یہ آپ کے سامنے قصیدہ بردشی پڑھیں گے. تو تشریف لاتے ہیں محمد حسن. مجھے امید ہے کہ آپ حضرات ان کا ساتھ دیں گے اور اچھے طریقے کے ساتھ ان کے ساتھ مل کے آپ قصیدہ بردہ شریف پڑھیں گے. قصیدہ بردہ شریف یہ 156 شعروں پہ لکھی ہوئی نبی اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم کی وہ نعت ہے کہ جب امام شرف الدین بوسیری نے فالج کی حالت میں وہ مفلوج تھے اور انہوں نے یہ نعت لکھی تھی جو ابھی یہ بچہ پڑھے گا, تو اس نعت کو لکھنے کے بعد انہیں خواب میں نبی اکرم صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم کی زیارت ہوئی تھی. یہ قصیدہ لکھ کے انہوں نے اپنے سرانے کے پاس رکھ دیا تھا یا دل میں سوچا تھا اور ابھی کسی کو سنایا نہیں تھا, مگر حضور خواب میں آئے اور حضور نے فرمایا کہ اے بصیری مجھے قصیدہ سناؤ جو تم نے میری شان میں لکھا ہے. تو امام بصیری نے عرض کی یا رسول اللہ میں نے تو کئی شعر کئی قصیدے آپ کی شان میں لکھے ہیں, کون سا سناؤں؟ حضور نے فرمایا جو آج رات تم نے لکھا ہے اور ابھی تک کسی کو نہیں سنایا سب سے پہلے وہ مجھے سناؤ. اور پھر حضور نے اس قصیدے کا پہلا شعر پڑھ کے سنایا, امن تذکری جیرا نم بزی سلامی مزج تدم ان جرامی مقلتم بدمی. حضور نے فرمایا یہ والا قصیدہ پڑھ کے سناؤ, اور امام شرف الدین بوسیری نے خواب میں یہ قصیدہ پڑھا حضور کو سنایا, اور حضور نے خواب میں ان کے جسم پہ ایسے ہاتھ پھیرا اور اپنی چادر بھی انہیں عطا فرمائی. تو امام شرف الدین بوسیری فرماتے ہیں کہ جب میں صبح اٹھا تو میرا فالج بھی دور ہو چکا تھا, میرا جسم ٹھیک ہو گیا تھا, اور حضور کی دی ہوئی چادر بھی میرے سرانے پہ پڑی ہوئی تھی. اسی لیے اس کو بردہ شریف کہتے ہیں. بردہ عربی زبان میں چادر کو کہا جاتا ہے, تو چونکہ اس کو سننے کے بعد حضور نے چادر عطا کی تھی اس لیے اسے قصیدہ بردہ شریف کہا جاتا ہے. تشریف لاتے ہیں محمد حسن, یہ آپ کے سامنے قصیدہ بردہ شریف کی تلاوت کریں گے.
وأجمل منك لم تر قط عين وأطيب منك لم تلد النساء خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء قمر 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 سدنا النبي قمر وجميل 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 سدنا النبي جميل كحين الطرف حبيبي لو تراه الله الله ضحوك السن للعاشق رماه الله الله كحين الطرف حبيبي لو تراه الله الله ضحوك السن للعاشق رماه الله الله بهي الطلعة فالمولى اصطفاه بهي الطلعة فالمولى اصطفاه بهي الطلعة فالمولى اصطفاه حبيب الله يا خير البرى يا قمر 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 سدنا قمر وجميل 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 سدنا النبي ميل وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي الله عطرها يبقى إذا مست يدي الله الله وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي الله عطرها يبقى إذا مست يدي الله الله وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد حبيب الله يا خير البرى يا قمر 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 سيدنا النبي قمر وجميل 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 بي وجميل ولا ظل له بل كان نورا الله تنال الشمس منه والبدور الله ولا ظل له بل كان نورا الله تنال الشمس منه والبدور الله ولم يكن الهدى لولا ظهورا ولم يكن الهدى لولا ظهورا ولم يكن الهدى لولا ظهورا وكل الكون أنار بنور طه ها قمرون قمرون قمر سيدنا النبي قمرون وجميل 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 وعرق المصطفى للطيب طيبا الله وطيبة شريفت بالنور طيبا الله وعرق المصطفى للطيب طيبا الله الله وطيبة شريفت بالنور طيبا الله الله ويدهش عند طلعته الحبيبة ويدهش عند طلعته الحبيبة ويدهش عند طلعته الحبيبة وإن جن المشاهد لما لا ما قمرون قمرون قمر سيدنا النبي قمر وجميل وجميل سيدنا النبي وجميل وريق المصطفى يشفي العليل الله وعين علي فاخذها دليلا الله ونيق المصطفى يشفي العليل الله وعين قتادة فاخذها دليلا الله تفلفل بئر أضحت سلسبيلا تفلفل بئر أضحت سلسبيلا تفلفل بئر أضحت السلسبيلا وصار لصحبه شهدا مداما قمرون قمرون قمر سيدنا النبي قمرون وجميل 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 سيدنا النبي وجميل.
ماشاءاللہ حافظ محمد حسن صاحب آپ کے سامنے قصیدہ پیش کر رہے تھے. وہ اصل میں مجھے مغالطہ ہوا کہ شاید یہ قصیدہ بردہ شریف پڑھیں گے، مگر وہ چونکہ ہمارے سامنے جب مطلق قصیدہ کہا جاتا ہے پاکستانیوں کے سامنے تو اس سے قصیدہ بردہ شریف مراد ہوتا ہے، لیکن انہوں نے بہت اچھے طریقے سے پڑھا اور آپ حضرات نے ان کا ساتھ بھی دیا. اب ہمارے پاس ایک نعت خوان تشریف فرما ہے، پاکستان کے شہر گجرات کے ایک علاقے ڈنگا سے تشریف لائے ہیں جناب محترم حافظ قاری محمد ابرار حسین قادری صاحب. تو جو قصیدہ بردہ شریف آپ سے کہا گیا تھا، اب یہ آپ کو قصیدہ بردہ شریف بھی آپ کے ساتھ پڑھیں گے، اور آپ انشاءاللہ امید ہے کہ آپ بھی ان کے پیچھے مل کے پڑھیں گے، اس سے خیر و برکت بھی ہوگی اور یہ آپ کے سامنے نعت مبارکہ بھی پیش کریں گے. تشریف لاتے ہیں حافظ قاری محمد ابرار حسین صاحب.
سبھی احباب مل کر قصیدہ بردہ پیش فرمائیں. مولا یا صلی وسلم دائما آبادا علی حبیبک خیر الخلق کلہم. مولا یا صلی وسلم دائما آبادا علی حبیبک خیر الخلق. هو الحبیب الذی ترجا شفاعته. هو الحبیب الذی ترجا شفاعته آتوه لكل حول من الأحوال مقتحم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كل محمد نيني و محمد نيني و نيني و ريقيني من عرب ومن عجم. مولاي صل أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كل. يا ربي بالمعيدة يا ربي استغفر مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. صل أبدا على أبي بالخلق لهمي مولاي صلي وأبدا أبدا على أبيك الخلق كلهم.
اب اردو پنجابی جاننے اور سمجھنے والوں کے لیے ایک اردو کلام نعتیہ پیش کر رہا ہوں اور ساتھ اس کے پنجابی عارفے کھڑی کے پیش کرتا ہوں.
دلوں سے غم مٹا محمد نام دلوں مٹاتا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے دلوں سے غم مٹا محمد نام نگر اجڑے آتا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے نگر اجڑے بسا ہے محمد نام ہے.
ایک دفعہ جو اردو پنجابی سمجھتے ہیں ذرا کہیں سبحان اللہ ماشاءاللہ.
انہیں کہنا شہشاہ انہیں کہنا فقیروں نے شہشاہ خدا سے بھی ہے محمد نام خدا سے بھی ملا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے درودوں کی مہک سے مدد حاصل ہے مجھ کو ہر
محمد نام ایسا ہے میری بگڑی بناتا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے دلوں سے غم مٹاتا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے نگر اجڑے بساتا ہے محمد نام ایسا ہے
ایک دفعہ کہیے ذرا سبحان اللہ
چنگے آتا تے ہر کوئی بندا مندے آتا میری چولی عمل خالی
Our respected and honorable guest has entered the mosque. I mean, Fazilatul Sheikh Al-Hazratul Allam Wal-Faqihul Faham Hazrat Sheikh محمد ابراہیم اوصیفہ دامت فیوزکم القدسیہ ادام اللہ ذلہ الشریف علی رؤوسنا میں اپنے معزز مہمان سے گزارش کروں گا کہ وہ منبر پہ تشریف لائیں اور اپنے خطاب کی ابتدا کریں تشریف لاتے ہیں حضرت الشیخ محمد ابراہیم اوصیفہ
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمداً يوافي نعمه يكافي مزيداً يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي للجلال وشكر العظيم سلطانك سبحانك لا نحصي ثناءً عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك فلك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم صلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد في كل وقت وحين وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد في الملا العلى إلى يوم الدين وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها أنت خير الوارثين الحمد لله we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all that he bestows subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of the means of all bestowal who is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والله هو المعطي وإنني أنا قاسم الله سبحانه وتعالى is the bestower and I am the distributor he said صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم and the distribution of the prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم on behalf of الحنان المنان سبحانه وتعالى there is no greater than that which the prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم has distributed unto us than himself, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, who is the supreme ni'mah and the supreme minna. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا And we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bestowal of the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and all that comes by virtue of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. We praise him for the gathering and we pray Same for the gathering inside of a place such as which we find ourselves in, which is the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he told us, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِالْرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا That if you pass by one of the meadows of paradise, then graze therein. They asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, وَمَا الْرِيَاضُ الْجَنَّةِ What are the meadows of paradise? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, In the riwayah, he said al-masajid, he said the mosques. And so we find ourselves in one of the meadows of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that we find ourselves in one of the masajid, the mosques of Allah jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu. They asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, wa ma riyadu jannah, what are the meadows of paradise? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the riwayah, he said hilaq al-ilmi, he said the circles of knowledge. And we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the distribution of knowledge by virtue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that we now embrace and we receive, and by virtue of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has installed mimma la ayn ra'at wa la udhunun sami'at wa ma khatar ala qalbi bashar, that which no eye has seen and no ear has heard, and likewise never has occurred to the hearts of man. Likewise, they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, wa ma riyadu jannah, what are the meadows of paradise? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he said hilak al-dhikr. He said the circles of remembrance, the circles of invoking the divine Jalla Jalala wa Ta'ata Azamato, which is the very purpose why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created each and every single one of us, because he's created us in purpose, subhanahu wa ta'ala, with a purpose, and that purpose is none but him Jalla Jalala wa Ta'ata Azamato. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuses save that he be invoked, that he be remembered. Subhanahu wa ta'ala al-madhkur al-akbar al-madhkur bil-haq jalla jalalu wa ta'ata azamatu wa ma khalaqathu jinna wal insa illa liya'buduni, that I only created any mankind, jinn kind, to worship me. And worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no doubt, first and foremost, crystallizes in knowledge of the divine jalla jalalu wa ta'ata azamatu, which is why Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas rahimahullah ta'ala, that he interpreted the verse here in Dhariyat as illa liya'rifunani, save to know me. That we were created in order to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But whenever we speak about the irfan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or ma'rifatullah, it's not an abstraction. It is not knowledge, quote unquote, that somehow roots itself inside the intellect of the human being and then thereby is confined to the human intellect. But whenever we use the word irfan or we use the word ma'rifah, it's a knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of experience. It's how we experience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala physically. It's how we experience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rationally. And more importantly, it's how we experience Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spiritually. Such that we come not only into knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we come into knowledge of our purpose. I had the very reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he created each and every single one of us. A crystallization of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is found inside of prayer. But prayer likewise has a aim. Prayer likewise has an objective. Prayer likewise also has a purpose. And that is which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, aqim as-salah, aqimu as-salah li-dhikri. For my remembrance, he says, jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamato. The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you remember Allah jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamato. The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are remembered by Allah jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamato. Udhkuruni adhkurkum, and it remember me and I will remember you. Akadri says subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not a single one of us, nadhkurullaha, do we mention and invoke and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, save that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers you alone. And not a single one of us who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as we currently do, fil mala', inside of a mala', inside of a gathering, save that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember us inside of a gathering that is better than the gathering in which we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala therein. And the supreme gathering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a gathering in which you find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam embedded therein. There's not a single one of us who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, save that by virtue of that we remember the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereby remembers us, and so does the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam remember us, and thereby become present in the gatherings that we find ourselves in. Yani al-awliya idha dhukiru hadaru. That the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who the people of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, when they remember that they become present. Now there's an antonym to dhikr, and thereby there's an antonym to our purpose. And the antonym to dhikr is ghafla. is heedlessness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never created us to be heedless. He never created us to be heedless of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never created us to be heedless of His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallama. He never created us to be heedless of the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself says, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikr, that we are the ones who reveal the dhikr. He never created us to be heedless of the dhikr of the Quran. He never created us to be heedless of those people who follow Sayyidina Wali Adnan sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as fasalu ahl al-dhikr, ask the people of the dhikr in kuntum la ta'alamuna, if you are somebody who is heedless, so you are somebody who is ignorant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for remembrance and not for heedlessness of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ramifications. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he told us, إِذَا دَخَلَ الرَّمَضَانِ, that when Ramadan enters, فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابِ الجنان وَغُلِّقَ أَبْوَابِ النِّيرَانِ وَصُفِّدَتَ الشَّيَاطِينِ. He says in al-Bukhari sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when paradise enters, that the gateways of paradise, that they flung open. From those gateways of paradise is a gateway that is known as dhikr, of the gateways. A gateway that is known as remembrance, is known as invocation of everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever invoked and ever remembered, up to and including Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there's nobody who remembers and invokes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself. But likewise also, just as paradise has gateways, likewise also, unfortunately, hell fire also has gateways. And those gateways ultimately are consequences, quote unquote, of a disobedience that the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who fails to fulfill his purpose, ultimately, quote unquote, becomes characterized by that disobedience. And so ghafla, heedlessness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a trait of disobedience, possibly, quote unquote, the root, quote unquote, cause of all disobedience to Allah Jalalu wa Ta'azamatu. We see, quote unquote, an age in which, whether for good fortune or for otherwise, we find ourselves in, that we see consequences of heedlessness unfold, quote unquote, inside of the environments and the age in which all of us find ourselves in. This fasad dhahar, al-fasada fil barri wal bahar. Dhahar al-fasadu fil barri wal bahar. That corruption has appeared upon land and sea due to, quote unquote, that which man's hands have aimed, that which man's tongues have aimed, that which man's heart has aimed. We see places that are invoked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being desecrated by man. And that desecration, quote unquote, ultimately usually doesn't manifest, quote unquote, originally upon the hands of an individual, but it roots itself, quote unquote, back into the hearts of those ultimately who should know better. We see places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has esteemed, Mecca al-Mukarramah, in the age in which we find ourselves being desecrated. We see Medina al-Munawwara, the very land of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that was sanctified by the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, in which is found a space, khayru min al-arsh, that is better than the very throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The very place where we now found the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam in perfect reality. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, fulfilling his purpose that he fulfilled not just in life, but he fulfills likewise now inside the barzakh. If the Prophet, says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, ahya'un fi quburihim yusallun, that they're alive inside of their graves praying, fa kayfa bi Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. We see the likes of Jerusalem and the land, the Aknaf, those blessed places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Barakna hawla, the places that we blessed its entire surroundings. We see them being desecrated at the hands of man, rooted into the hearts, quote unquote, of those who know better. We see places that embrace, quote unquote, the forms of great people, from those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he addressed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taqallubuka fi sajidina, that you're sojourning inside of the loins of those who fall prostrate unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the sajidin ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani Hashim ibn Abd Manaf, the great grandfather of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama, and is another land of Gaza, of Gaza, that what embraces the very form of the great grandfather of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama. The reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unfolds fasad, jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu, and the roots itself back to ghafla, the heedlessness, that quote unquote, those who showed no better, yani find themselves in a state of. And thereby, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, la'allakum yarji'una, la'allakum tarji'una, in the hope that they, and likewise you, return back to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That whenever we see the mizan, the actual scales, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of balance in which he created his universe in jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu, disturbed, it becomes an ultimate sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not just wants or desires, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demands a return back to him, jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us opportunity. And him subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives us opportunity after opportunity, jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu, facilitated by the greatest of all facilitators on the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he facilitates jalla jalala wa ta'ata azamatu through the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama by placing those amongst an ummah, the likes of which have never graced the earth. Just like the Prophet himself sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, the likes of him has never and will never grace the earth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, likewise the ummah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, kuntum khayra ummah ukhrijat linnas, you are the best ummah, the best nation that has ever been brought forth for humanity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, addressing the ummah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, in particular those formative generations, those fullatu min al-awwalina wa qaleelu min al-akhirina, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself articulates subhanahu wa ta'ala, great number that were from the formative generations, very few, quote unquote, through the passage of time will thereby remain, but they do remain. And by virtue of them remaining, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a gaze upon the face of the earth subhanahu wa ta'ala, if, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us inside of Sahih al-Bukhari, that inna Allah nadhara ila al-khalqi, that are inside of Sahih Muslim, inna Allah nadhara ila al-khalqi arabahum wa ajamahum, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gazed at the entire creation, whether they be Arab or whether they be non-Arab, wa maqatahum jami'an, and the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was upon all of them, illa baqaya min ahlil kitab, except for a few people who remain, quote unquote, from the continuum of those who came before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. If that was the nadhra, the gaze of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what about the gaze of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the ummah of the Rasul himself sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam? In al-khair, goodness, mawjood. It still exists inside the ummah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, but becomes the property of specific people. Yani anfas, mashallah, tabarakallah, who lived their life in fulfillment of the purpose that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them in. Yani these are the people of dhikr. And these are the ones, mashallah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam has raced ahead and have got off with all of the reward. Yani radiallahu ta'ala anhum wa radahum. These are the sabiqoon, as-sabiqoon. These are the muqarrabun. These are the ones who jannatul na'im, that the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been prepared for. But just as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ultimately becomes an intermediary for them, then likewise also they also become an intermediary for us to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and ultimately unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, we must take advantage of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must seek the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must seek the proximity of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must seek a gaze upon the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, nadhra ila al-alam, and nadhra ila al-alam khayru min ibadat al-sana indi. That one glance at a scholar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is better than ibadat al-sana. It's better than worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for an entire year. And the Rasul is not mentioning it abstractly, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, indi, with me. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, qiyamuha wa siyamuha, standing for the entire year in prayer, fasting for the entire year in prayer. As you heard our dear Shaykh make mention of the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, rahimahullah ta'ala, about what learning one single verse
is better than 100 rak'at with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what about one gaze at a scholar? That's better than an entire year. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, continually praying, continually fasting. What about that, the gazing at the scholar? But better than gazing at a scholar is having that scholar gaze at you. Is having the people of earth, the people who inherit the eyes of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam, gazing at you. And the reality is, whether it's something that we understand, quote unquote, in cosmology, or something that we understand in terms of theology, it's by virtue of sight. It's by virtue of whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gazes upon. It's by virtue of whom, innaka bi'ayunina, you are in our eyes. By whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam gazes upon. Allah muhawwal, yuhawwal, mughayyir, yughayyir, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who transforms subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he transforms Jalla Jalala wa Ta'ala Azamato by virtue of that nadhra, by virtue of that gaze. And so we must take advantage of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we must take advantage of those quote unquote spaces or dimensions, quote unquote, that are sanctified by the very reality of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani what is quote unquote space or place without the people, mashallah ta'ala, gaze upon his face? Yani what is it? Yani Mecca is sanctified by beings. Yani Medina is sanctified by a being. Jerusalem is sanctified by beings. The Masajid are special with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of beings. It's human beings that sanctify place. But likewise also it's human beings, quote unquote, that will sanctify time. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unfolded for us a great period of time, Rajab. We came out of that month that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Shahrullah. He called it a month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And which one of us found Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala therein? There is many, quote unquote, from our age all the way tracing back to the age of Nabuwa, who find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Rajab. Which one of us are part of that continuum? Which one of us saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside of the month of Rajab? There are many, mashallah ta'ala, the ummah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam, tracing its way all the way back to the one who saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Rajab, Qabil Qawsain aw Adna, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam, who continually see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside of the month of Rajab. Which one of us, we procured the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We procured the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We procured the turning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tawbah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabba ghfirli. As we recounted each and every single morning and evening as instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as informed that the one who says Rabbaghfirli warhamni wa tub alay 70 marra, yani 70 times by morning and evening inside of the month of Rajab, after Fajr and after Isha, the fire will not touch their physical form. Yani which one of us, yani prepared, quote unquote, his mercy and his forgiveness and his tailing jalala wa ta'ata azamato. Or likewise the ma'iyyah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama, hakadha, and the witness being with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, unfolds ultimately inside of the month of Rajab. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama, and the ma'urij, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was raised unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there, inside beyond the skies, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama hears the voice of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. That the sahib Rasulillah, that the khalil Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama, that wherever he may be sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama, fathamma Abu Bakr, then there likewise is Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wardahu. But Abu Bakr doesn't stand alone. And our teacher, Habib Umar, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, he said at the end of time, there will be people, mashallah ta'ala, who yawmul qiyamah, although they find themselves in the depth of kufr, in the depths of disbelief, yawmul qiyamah, they'll be raised in the ranks of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Yani radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. Abu Bakr, yani, symbolizes those of ma'iyyah, those of witness with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahihi wa sallam, those of a deep and a profound connection to the Rasul himself sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahihi wa sallam. But the deen does not embrace ghafla, heedlessness. He said sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahihi wa sallam, there's a month that lies in between two months, two great months, that most people ghafilina, they're heedless of. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, a great month, Rajab, a great month indeed. An even greater month, Ramadan, mashallah ta'ala, Sayyid al-Shuhur. He says in Bukhari, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the master of all months. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, but the believer Ibn al-Waqt, he's the son of the moment to which he finds himself in. And we find ourselves as sons and of daughters of the moment inside of the blessed month of Sha'ban, the month that the majority of people are heedless of. Hakada kalam as-sadiq al-masduq sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And the heedlessness of Sha'ban, yani by extension, is the heedlessness of Ramadan. And the heedlessness of Sha'ban, more importantly, is the heedlessness of Sayyid Ramadan wa Sayyid al-Wadli Adnan sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, because he's the one who said, Sha'ban shahri, Sha'ban is my month. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And so we thank Allah ta'ala and we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what he unfolds. Because whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unfolds, he unfolds for purpose as a means by virtue of which we all fulfill our purpose inside of life, which is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his remembrance, yani subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us, that he comes, yani liyuzakkikum, that he comes in order to purify, yani sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that each and every single one of us, by virtue of the heedlessness that we're characterized by, no heedlessness that exists between us and the great people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, heedlessness that exists between us and the great places of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and heedlessness that exists between us and the great times in which we quote unquote find ourselves in. And we look at the age of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those who were situated around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no mountain too high, no valley too deep that would prevent them from being in the very presence of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. From where did Sayyidina Salman al-Farisi come from? And from where, yani, from where did Sayyidina Suhaib al-Rumi and radiallahu anhu wardahu come from? Then in knowledge of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, they journeyed and they sojourned to the very presence of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, save that mountain tops and valleys and oceans lie between us and the people of Allah jalla jalalu wa ta'azamatu. Yani there are those, mashallah ta'ala, in the age of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, they did that which was proper in terms of time. Yani they fulfilled, mashallah ta'ala, the mandate of time as it relates to Ramadan. Yani as it relates to mashallah to Rajab, Al Fard, Al Asam, Al Asab, that relates to Dhul Qa'dah and Dhul Hijjah and Muharram. And they fulfilled it, mashallah, tabarakallah. Because you imagine there are people that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, in the Bukhari, when he spoke about the Ansar, and those people who were situated around the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, from the blessed soil and earth of Madinatul Munawwara, that they have fulfilled everything that is upon them. That's what he said. What type of shahada is that? What type of testimony is that? That they fulfilled everything that is upon them. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Bukhari says about them. What then is it that we have fulfilled? There are those, mashallah ta'ala, who could not quote in the age of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. It is inconceivable, inconceivable, that what we see unfold inside of Palestine, inside of Gaza now, could have happened in the age of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, with Juffa and Qul'uda, when we just quote would sit idly by. Not a single one of us, whether ra'i or ra'iya, doesn't matter whether it's those who rule or those who are ruled. It doesn't matter whether it's rijal or nisa, whether it's men or it's women. Doesn't matter, yani. Like we sit idly by and we watch unfold what is unfolding in front of our very eyes. And quote, you know, the pain maybe that quote inflicts the heart of some, it renders us oblivious in a state of heedlessness as to what exactly is taking place, as if we will not be raised in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and questioned in front of Allah jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. You know, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, it is more difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see the blood of a single believer shed than to see the Kaaba destroyed brick by brick. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, then what then do you think about those, mashallah, embedded inside of the land of the forefather Hashim, embedded inside of the land of what the prophets of Israel and the very land upon which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's feet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam tread upon, and likewise by extension blessed. There has to be rujoo'. You have to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Akada. And it's Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala. These signs, they manifest as a means of return back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so thereby we begin to fulfill, quote, quote, the dictates of the moments in which we find in the likes of Sha'ban. And so we read about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, al-muqtaba, al-muqtada, al-rasul, the one who came to be followed. In kuntum tuhibbun allaha, fattabi'un, if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the claim that all of us make, then follow me, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. It's not a conditional following of the Rasul. It's not a partial following of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just like it's not a conditional following of the book or a partial following of the book. تُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْدُ الْكِتَابُ وَتَكْفَرُونَ بِبَعْدُ. You're going to believe in some of the book, but you're going to ignore other parts of the book. You're going to pick and choose, quote unquote, what it is of this great religion that came from beyond seven skies that you, quote, will feel is suitable for you inside of your place, inside of your age. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuses that. Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala. So we gaze at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by means of gazing at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, maybe thereby we find a path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that the month, mashallah ta'ala, is a month, mashallah ta'ala, fasting. That is the only month that we find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is supererogatory, that the Prophet doesn't fast the entire month. And so we must ask serious questions. That when Maghrib comes, where does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala find us? You know, for the Rasul, when you hear that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in hadith of Sayyidina Hafsa, رضي الله عنها ورضاها حديث سيدنا أم سلمة رضي الله عنها ورضاها that when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fasts the entire month of Sha'ban, and you know by extension that the Prophet doesn't fast the entire month of Ramadan صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم, there is something about Sha'ban that mirrors Ramadan in the eyes of the Rasul صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. Now the greatness of Ramadan, mashallah ta'ala, first and foremost is by virtue of the prescription of fasting therein. يعني كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. That the fasting has been prescribed for you, just as it's been prescribed for those who went before you. لعلكم تتقون, that you may become people of taqwa. But التقوى ها هنا, التقوى ها هنا, التقوى ها هنا, he says عليه وسلم, التقوى lies here in the heart of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not manifest that upon the tongue of the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, say that it's inside of a month that mirrors Ramadan, which is the month of Sha'ban. That's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala articulated that verse for all eternity, Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamatu, inside of the month of Sha'ban. And so the month of Sha'ban, it becomes a means by virtue of which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم shows his ummah how to purify themselves, mashallah, tabarakallah, of all of those things that have veiled us between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Kullu amal ibn Adam lah. Hakadha Allah ta'ala in Bukhari says, every single act of the human being is for him. Every act. You get a portion of your prayer. And some of us, the majority of the portion of prayer is for us. And we find ourselves in the midst of prayer in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, heedless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like you find yourself in the midst of prayer, yani saying that which you're not cognizant of. As if there's a type of delirium or a type of drunkenness in the midst of prayer. Sometimes you can't even remember what surah, quote unquote, that you recited in the midst of prayer in and of itself. What type of heedlessness is that of prayer? And the Prophet ﷺ told us that a person only gets from the prayer ma'aqila min, that which he's conscious of and cognizant of. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And so then the majority of the prayer lak is for you, not lahu, not for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you're given for the sake of Allah, jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato, lak, it's for you. Not for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in al-Bukhari al-Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it says, sabah. Yudhilluhum Allahu yawma la dhilla la dhillu. That there are going to be seven under the shade of Allah ta'ala on a day when there's no shade. One of them, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, a man whose left hand doesn't know what his right hand gives. He's not conscious of the act of giving in the best and all senses, mashallah, tabarakallah. Because it ain't for him, it's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the Imams, rahimahullah ta'ala, they tell us, give us a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted an act. They say a sign that Allah has accepted an act that is no longer tangible upon the face of the earth. It no longer exists, quote unquote, inside of your memory. It's gone. Because amal as-salih, yarfa'u. Allah Ta'ala raises good deeds, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah Ta'ala raises good deeds to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're no longer perceptible on the face of the earth. Gone. Yani, you're what? You're going into the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether inside the month of Rajab, as Rajab, mashallah, was the original month for the Umrah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether going inside the month of Sha'ban, as we find, mashallah ta'ala, the food. People going into the month, to the sacred land, to the haram of Mecca and to Medina, Madawan inside of the Sha'ban. Likewise inside of Ramadan. But you find, mashallah, nasallahu salam al-afiyah, that the majority that lack, laysa lah, that is for you, it's not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the end of time will not come until the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, then going unto what? To Hajj is nuzha. It's just a holiday, yani. It's an excursion. Hakada kalam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for certain people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, tijara. It's just trade. You go into Mecca just for trade. You go into Medina just for trade. You go, nasallahu salam al-afiyah, unto the land sanctified, rendered sacred just for trade. Lack for you, laysa lah. Yani not for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then how? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, illa sawm, except fasting. هَذَا لِي That for me. جَلَّ جَلَالَ وَتَعَيْتَ عَذَمَتُ Then the effect that fasting has upon the heart of the slave is way beyond the effect that prayer and giving and hajj and its like could have combined. That one for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it purifies and يُخَلِّي It removes, quote unquote, from the heart of the slave these veils, mutarakima. That I begin to quote unquote ba'duha fawqa ba'd, that I begin to pile and to myelinate, quote unquote, on the heart of the human being, that only serves to veil them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such that they know him not and experience him not. Veils them from the Rasul sa'isim, such that they know him not and experience him not. And so yanhakada kama kutiba ala ladina min qablikum. In the same way it was prescribed for all those who went before you. It becomes dabba salihin, it becomes the very nature of those, mashallah, tabarakallah, who seek righteousness and piety with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finds them, mashallah ta'ala, in a state of wanting him subhanahu wa ta'ala and forsaking for his sake. Jalla jalala wa ta'ata adamatu, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, my slave, he's abandoned food and drink for my sake. Ana adzibi, I shall recompense that as I please. He says, Jalla jalala wa ta'ata adamatu. And so thereby we look at Ramadan, at Sha'ban with a different type of eye. No doubt preparatory for the month of Ramadan, but we look at it with a different type and an independent type of eye also. That we try to draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of an act that the Rasul demonstrated each and every single day of this month, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahibu sallam, an act. That we know the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahibu sallam, in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asked, why do you fast upon Mondays? Why? Why does the Rasul fast upon Mondays, each and every single Monday, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ الَّذِي وُلِدْتُ فِيهِ Because that is the day on which I was born. That day Mawlid of the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That day celebrating the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the very act of fasting. And thereby, if the Rasul sighs and fasts upon every single Monday after celebrating his birthday, then what about Sha'ban Shahri? What then about Sha'ban is my month? The Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alihi wa sahibu sallam, it informed us. But fasting, as we reduce this great religion, mashallah ta'ala, down to great pillars, two great pillars, a pillar of takhalli and a pillar of tahalli, a pillar that rids our heart, nasal Allah salam wa al-afiyah, yani min kulli aghyar, from all of those others, than him jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamato, but thereby when the heart is emptied, we also need now the heart, quote, to be filled with that which procures his proximity, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as well as his love. And that they dhikr. That dhikr benefits when the heart is empty of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what you call tahalli. Atakhalli qabla tahalli. That we must cleanse the heart first. That's the act of fasting. Mashallah, and Sha'ban represents that. In order that we become people, natahalla, the people that now we adorn our heart and we fill our heart with that which, mashallah, is beloved to the madhkur, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That being his dhikr, jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamato, the dhikr of Allah ta'ala. What is the dhikr of God? You know what ma'ana? What do you mean the dhikr of God? What is the dhikr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does? Our Shaykh assisted us today. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. That ذكر الله تعالى. The ذكر of Allah تعالى, the ذكر of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the منان سبحانه وتعالى, the benefactor سبحانه وتعالى in his munificence has opened up the gateway for us likewise, quote unquote, to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not is already doing, but there's not a quote with the concept of time, say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been doing it, jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamato. When there was no such thing as place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was invoking Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When there was no such thing as time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was invoking the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. When there was no such thing as being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was invoking the Rasul, كان الله ولم يكن شيء معه. Allah was and there was nothing besides him subhanahu wa ta'ala, but still he was invoking the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. There is no dhikr that is more potent, quote unquote, upon the heart and the purification of the heart, the means by virtue of which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, than salawat ala nabi. Than moisten our tongues in invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he embraces the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam in mercy and love concomitant with all exaltation. Jalla jalalu wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. Nothing greater than that. And remember, it was in this month, likewise, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, that the very verse was first articulated by the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So thereby it becomes a means by virtue of which we characterize ourselves with. Yani, tribulation that we see upon the face of the earth has only just begun. If you want to consider that to be a beginning. Because the tongue of truth, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, has foretold exactly what's going to unfold, quote unquote, in the ages that we find ourselves in and the ages that lie beyond. And likewise, it's also foretold, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that there'll be a blessed people who will be brought forth, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, a blessed people. And those blessed people that they'll find themselves, come may it be, inside of that blessed place, Jerusalem, Aknaf, Bayt al-Maqdis, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, people disciplined and trained, quote unquote, inside of the likes of this month of Sha'ban, such that food, quote unquote, has real no value inside of their lives. No value. None. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed them that they have nothing, quote, could consume that you would call physical. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, yani wa ardahum, just like they asked, wa man riyadu jannah ya Rasulullah, wa O Messenger of God, they asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ma qutuhum yawma idhin, then what then is this, how do they sustain themselves upon that day inside of Jerusalem, ya Rasulullah? And the Prophet sallallahu wa sallam, he said, dhikr. Qutuhum dhikrullah. That their qut, their sustenance is the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think it just happens all of a sudden. That is a training that they approach day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year. It's a discipline the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have. And especially those moments that, mashallah, represent quantum leaps with Allah ta'ala, i.e. facilitation from the divine. Yani Sha'ban, the fasting of it in its entirety, is facilitated by Ar-Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani easier, mashallah, to fast the entire month of Sha'ban than it is to fast the entire month of Rajab. Or the entire months of Jumada, or the entire months of Rabi al-Awwal wa Thani, easier. Because the sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam facilitates. Just like Allah Ta'ala said, we made it easy. The Quran, bi lisanika, by virtue of your tongue. What about everything else of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Does it not make what religion easier by virtue of places in which we stand or times in which we find ourselves in? And so thereby opportunities we take. Opportunities we take, we become people, inshallah ta'ala, who prepare for Ramadan, such that we become people of the fast. And we emerge from Ramadan as people of the fast. Like the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who follows up Ramadan bisit min al-shawwal, who follows up with 6 days of shawwal, ka'annahu sama dahar. It's as if he fasted dahar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. Whether dahar means an entire year, or whether dahar means an all eternally, we shall know, kum may it be, yawm al-qiyamah. What was the intent of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam? But they take the moment. They take the moment of facilitation to moisten their tongue. لا يزال لسانك رطبا بذكر الله يا معاذ يحبك. You know, the Rasul loves the person sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gives them. And of the things the Rasul said in the Musnad of Ahmad bin Hanbal, saying to Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Ya Mu'adh inni yuhibbuka. Oh Mu'adh, I love you. I love you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yazal lisanuka ratban bi dhikrillah. And so always ensure that your tongue is moist in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the remembrance of Allah ta'ala is of degrees. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for tawfiq, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us his success and his providence subhanahu wa ta'ala, most of all by virtue of his gaze, jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ties us to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam by virtue of that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated inside of this month. This month in particular, the month of Sha'ban. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that he's informed us upon the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that when paradise, when Ramadan enters, that the gateways of paradise are flung open. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sahih al-Bukhari, informed us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the gateway of prayer. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to become ahl al-tahakkuk of those who will realize prayer, aqim al-salali dhikri, establishing prayer for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as he informed us, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, that is a gateway called the gateway of sadaqah. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us people of tasadduq, and the people who give, such that our left hand is completely unaware of what our right hand gives, such that we find ourselves beneath the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a day when there's no shade. Just like he informed us, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, of the gateway of rayyan, of the gateway of the quencher, a gateway, as he said in Bukhari, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, la yadkhulu illa sa'imuna. The only one who entered are those who habitually fast. They look for 6 days in Shawwal and they fast. They look for Mondays and Thursdays and they fast. They look for first, second and third of the month and they fast. They look for 13th, 14th and 15th white nights and they fast. They look for 28th and the 29th and it is the 30th, then they likewise, they're going to fast. They're going to look for the sacred months, Dhulqa'dah, Dhulhijjah, Muharram, Rajab, then they're going to fast. They're going to fast. Wal fajri wal layalin ashar wal shafi' al watar. They're going to fast those days inside of what, mashallah, Dhulhijjah, that are blessed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first nine. Just like they look for the Muharram, the Ashura, and the nine before the Ashura, the Tasu'a, and the 11th of Muharram, such that they fast. The Ahlul Tatabbur, the people who follow the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, whenever he places his footstep inside of a specific act, then they act. If he places his footstep inside of a fast, then they fast. And when it comes to the month, the likes of the month of Sha'ban, hakada, now they've reached critical mass at this point in time. And so they know not a day, quote unquote, where they fast, such that possibly, as in the hadith in Abu Dawood and Tirmidhi and others, that what, they're going to be barred from fasting of fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he said in Tasafa Sha'ban, that when Sha'ban reaches its midpoint, that what a person who does not fast, they do not fast, they cannot fast. And as many of the fuqaha, like the imams, as an example, the Shafi'i school, said it's haram to fast after the 15th. Quote, if you've not fasted on the 15th or the days prior. And according to the fuqaha, and many of the fuqaha, radiallahu ta'ala anhum warda'ahum. And what does it mean that you, because of a lack of something, you can bar yourself from it? You think that's what the Rasul wants you, for you? For you not to fast? Is good to win. Or is that he wants you to fast? Hakad al-ayyan. Wida ghuliq. And when that gateway is closed, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, nobody will enter it ever. Ever. That gateway. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa said, if there's a gateway, as he told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of Hajj, then we become, mashallah ta'ala, people of Hajj. And again, the basis and the meaning of Hajj is how the heart connects to lands that have been sanctified by the feet of those people who approximate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so thereby we exalt the lands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you add them. Sha'ir Allah finna min taqwa al-qulub. That the ones who exalt the sacred symbols of Allah ta'ala, that is from taqwa al-qulub. That is from a consciousness of the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but how can somebody exalt, quote unquote, yani Mecca, quote unquote, and exalt Madinatul Munawwara when they're not exalting Jerusalem and the lands that have been blessed around Jerusalem? How then? If it's the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that what, that there's a gateway that is known as jihad, likewise, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa told us, إِذَا بَايَعْتُمْ بِالْعِينَ وَاتَّبَعْتُمْ أَذْنَابَ الْبَقَرِ وَتَرَكْتُمُ الْجِهَادِ, that what, if you're going to now begin to deal with usury and you're going to follow the tales of cowboys, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied, Americano, And then you abandon jihad. The Prophet said, Allah Ta'ala will subjugate you to an enemy from without you, hatta tarji ila dinika, until you return back to your religion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wasallam said, it's clear as daylight, right? As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa said, tatada'a alaykum al-umam kama tada'a al-umat al-akhlatu ala qasa'atiha, that nations of the world will play with you in the same way diners will ravage a place of food. Is it due to our paucity numbers upon that day? La bal antum kathir. No, but you're great in number. But you're like the froth upon the ocean. وَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّ اللَّهُ مِنْ قُلُوبِ أَعْدَائِكُمْ Bring out of the heart of your enemies fear of you. وَلَقْذِفَنَّ اللَّهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَحَمْ And Allah Ta'ala will cast into your hearts وَحَمْ وَمَا الْوَحَمْ يَا رَسُولَ What's وَحَمْ O Messenger of God, حُبِّ الدُّنْيَا وَكَرَهِيَةَ الْمَوْتِ That you love the dunya and you're scared of dying. Yani believers don't love dunya. They love akhirah. Yani believers, they don't love life. Death. That's believers. جِتُكُمْ بِأُنَاسٍ يُحِبُّونَ الْمَوْتِ كَمَا تُحِبُّونَ الْحَيَاةِ I've come to you, the people who love death of life. هَكَذَا رَوَيْتُ الْقَالِ بِمُ وَلِيدِ رَحِيمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى That gateway is a gateway for a specific type of people. Likewise, all the other gateways, the gateway of tawakkul. There's a gateway called the gateway of reliance and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For whom will enter through that gateway? There's a gateway of kaadhi min al-ghayl, of those who are able to suppress rage. Who then will enter through that gateway? There's a gateway of dhikr, of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Gateway of ilm. Who then will enter through that gateway? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in months like these, he unfolds all of the gateways. Jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamata. So we try to ensure that we take, mashallah ta'ala, our due portion of everything from prayer to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all that that lies in between of those gateways unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will be cast open inside of the month of Ramadan upon the face of Rajab, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban. Oh Allah, bless us, increase us inside of Rajab and Sha'ban. وبلغنا رمضان هكذا نسأل الله تعالى ويسأل الله تعالى الله تعالى يباركنا في شعبان وما بقي من شعبان that Allah Ta'ala blesses inside of شعبان and all that remains of شعبان ويبلغنا رمضان يا رحمن
ما شاء الله The unforgettable speech of our Sheikh has come to an end. So I request to Hafiz Ahsan came here and recite the Salaam. Hafiz Ahsan is a respected member of our academic staff. Hafiz Muhammad Ahsan Sahib Tashreef Lati hain aur abhi hum Salaam padhenge. To Salaam ke baad Sheikh khususi dua farmayenge.
يا نبي سلام عليك يا سلام عليك حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك رحمتك تاج دو جہاں آج والے عرش کی معراج والے آسیوں کی لاج والے یا نبی سلام رسول سلام يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك جدر پہ پھر بلانا مدنی مدینے والے معیشت بھی پلانا مدنی ثانية الوداع وجاء
اے پروردگار عالم، ہماری آج کی محفل کو اپنی بارگاہ میں قبول و منظور فرما، اس کے طفیل ہم پہ رحمتوں کا نزول فرما۔ ہمارے قبلہ شیخ صاحب نے جو بیان کیا ہے، ہمیں کما حقہ اس پہ عمل کی توفیق عطا فرما۔ قبلہ شیخ صاحب کی توفیقات خیر اور مسائی جمیلہ میں برکتیں پیدا فرما۔ یا الہی، ہمیں اپنی زندگیاں ان کے خطاب کے مطابق اور ان کے خطاب میں جو قرآن و حدیث کی تعلیمات تھیں ان کے مطابق ڈھالنے کی توفیق عطا فرما۔ صلی اللہ تعالی علی خیر خلقہ محمد۔
بسم اللہ۔ For those, some of you will know that we're going to be going to the Clemency House now. There's a presentation taking place there. Sheikh Ibrahim will be there himself, and also Brother Mansoor will be there.